Hi, I'm Stardust, and welcome back for the conclusion of Anole Alley Episode 17, the season finale. Well, Brownie has become the leader of the chain gang, and you all remember Bo. He's 11 years old and suffers from glaucoma. His eyesight may be shot, but the Anole's eyesight is excellent, and Brownie sees Bo with no problem. These little Anoles are quite bold, too, and I have witnessed them holding their ground and defending their domains against some pretty big threats, such as the dogs. And here, Spider rests on top of this old birdhouse. It's been part of she and Leo's territory throughout the summer. And today, Leo is using this old blind for shelter. And there's a visitor, another small Anole. It could be Apollo. He's been spotted over here several times before. And he's probably interested in Spider. But she's taken for the moment. It's a cloudy and gray day today. A little cool. So the Anoles are just out trying to warm up and get their metabolisms going. It's almost Christmas. And our weather, well, it's about to change again. Another cold front is about to come through, and the temperatures are going right back down. Well, that's life here on the Gulf Coast, and winter is now in full swing. Over next to the fence, a lone member of the chain gang watches as the house lizards go about their usual business. The smaller Anole leaves and starts to climb back up to the top of the windowsill. Leo and Spider continue to make themselves perfectly at home. Leo loves using this old handrail as a superhighway from the top and the bottom steps. This is where he and Spider remained throughout the summer. Over on the hutch, another surprise. Athena has graced us again. We first saw her in the episode Space Invaders, nameless at the time. Again, she's brought along a friend. It's a handsome, older guy. And he's come out for a refreshing dip and sip in the water dish. And below, another handsome lizard also takes advantage of this warm spell. Just a few days ago, we were experiencing record low temperatures, and today we're experiencing record highs. The Anoles and other lizards need to rehydrate themselves. I've lost sight of Athena, but the large male is still enjoying his dip, while Caesar the iguana finishes his and proceeds over to chow down on some freshly diced fruit. Eventually, he'll have to be brought back indoors, as iguanas cannot take the cold weather like the Anoles can. Iguanas are truly tropical and need special care in the winter. As for this guy, it's a Dama. I can clearly tell by that telltale scar on his left side. We met a Dama in the episode, The Winds of Change. Starbuck has also come over, probably to get a dip and bask as well. While Adama visits for a while, Spider comes down to bask on the bricks. As you can see briefly, the spider plant that used to be her home has now been killed by the cold, as have the plants in the basket that Starbuck once called home. Also, look carefully, and you'll see that Adama also has two scars on his right side, clearly matching the one on the left. Looks like this old guy, at one time, escaped the jaws of a house cat. And Starbuck, well, he, or she, hopes to be as lucky and prosperous as Adama one day. That's one tough old guy. Adama starts to head back towards where he came from, the tall trees and shrubbery next to the house. Both he and Athena are known as the arboreal lizards, since they clearly make themselves at home high up in the treetops. Athena follows him closely as she too begins her retreat back into the trees. She is the epitome of a female Anole. She's beautiful and a great representative of her species. You can definitely see a difference in the shape of her head and the males. Females tend to have a shorter, broader head shape. Males are longer and slimmer. Another fact, you cannot tell the difference in the sexes by using the white stripe down the back test. It's only about 50% reliable, as some mature males also exhibit this trait. It's much easier to tell the differences using the shapes of the head and overall body size. Athena begins her trek back into the trees using almost the identical path as Adama just minutes before. What will become of them? What will happen to Starbuck? Apollo? And the rest of the Anoles over the remainder of the winter season. Well, we shall see.